nails are still good. Okay. Hello. Oh, good afternoon. How are you doing? Do you know where you are? Know when you are? Well, according to your chart, you were escorted in approximately 3 days ago. Some hitchhikers had found you unresponsive in a wooded area on some of the hiking trails. Okay. It was 3.5 days ago. Mm-hmm. So you do know where you are? Okay. What are the last couple events that you remember? Well, maybe just start from when you arrived. Did you get here by a vehicle? Did you hike here? Okay. Yeah, the people that had brought you in, they didn't really know much about you other than it looked like you had some topical scratches, possibly a concussion. You were bleeding a little bit out of the nose and out of the ear, so we've had you in observation for a couple of days, just making sure that, you know, you don't have any major infections, that your wounds were cleaned, and you were looked after. Alright, well, I guess coherently, let's just start from the beginning. And what's the date? Okay, you're close. Mm-hmm. Okay. And what were you doing at the resort? What was your initial plan? Okay. Hiking the trails? Did you do any jet skiing or water skiing? Okay. I'm just making the assumption based on the sunburn. That definitely could have happened elsewhere, yeah. Okay. And what's your first and last name? Well, now we can stop referring to you as John Doe. It's nice to meet you. Alrighty. Well, I'm one of the nurses on the shift here, so there's definitely going to be people passing through. I'm going to first update the current staff and let them know that you're becoming more awake and see what kind of measures they'd like me to take from here, okay? Alrighty. Is there anything I can get you in the immediate time frame that'll make you more comfortable? Are you thirsty, hungry? Okay, your eyes are dry. Just go ahead and close them for a little bit. I'll be right back. I'm just going to touch base with some people and give you a call right back, okay? I'll be right back. Okay. So, the doctor is not on staff at the moment, but they've gotten the update, and they would like me to do just some preliminary cranial tests to see if there's any signs of trauma, concussion, as well as if you're having any difficulty with some of your primary senses, and also you do have some topical wounds, so that I'm going to go over just to make sure that you're not developing any infections, anything like that, okay? Alright. Start first with the wound care, is that okay? And this will just involve me going over some of the areas it looks like you've had affected. Definitely let me know if there's anything alarming, painful, uncomfortable, if you feel pressure in one area, or if it triggers something like dizziness or nausea, okay? Alrighty. I'm gonna get a little bit close to you. Is that okay? I'm gonna remove some of the bandages that we have on here. They are quite dry, so I'm going to just apply a little bit of lubricant first. And this will soften up that tissue and make the removal process a lot easier. Okay? Go back a little bit. Tell me when you got here. When you got to the resort. Okay. How long were you intending on staying? Long time. Do you have any acquaintances or anybody here that you were staying with? Someone that I can contact? Well, no, the bystanders, they didn't bring any other materials. You had a backpack, but nothing like a phone or anything. Okay. Just the other side here. Just let that nice medicated ointment sink. So what happened once you arrived? Okay. Did you have any kind of fall that you can remember? So I'm going to try to gently lifting it off of the skin, okay? It's still a little bit sticky. I'll try my best to be really gentle. Drinking or any other drugs. I'm not here to judge. I just want to make sure that we can get you the right treatment if it's needed. Any family, anything like that? Okay. Grab a new cloth and just clean the area. I'm gonna use a little bit of disinfectant, is that okay? It might be a little bit zingy, but we'll make sure that the area stays nice and clean. Go ahead, please continue. Had to close some of these wounds. But no thread stitches, so that's always good. Okay. These little brainwave activity monitors also are stuck to your scalp. So I'm going to remove them and clean the skin on them. So making sure that you have nice good contact, but that sticky residue is sometimes very unpleasant. Let's just clean that area a little bit. So you don't have that sticky residue. Just a little bit more. Anything that has abnormal pressure or discomfort. It feels kind of like touching a bruise. Okay. Yeah, I know that doesn't feel very good. Okay. All right, and you got another one on your right side here, so let's try to sit still for me. Try to separate it without tugging on your hair too much. Okay. Go ahead, just close your eyes if it's more comfortable. We'll move on to some of the other tests in just a little bit, but right now it's just waking you back up a little bit. I'm going to reapply some of those butterfly stitches, so I'm going to just take some very precise tweezers and just going to rip it one by one, okay? You only have four of them. So our best guess is that you would fall on your right side. Skin is a little bit dry, so when we put an antibiotic on it, also make sure that we put something that's going to be moisturizing. Does that feel tender? I'm sorry. Okay. I'm going to rest just for a little bit. The sign we assume you fell on. Just want to make sure that if you have any debris that's still building up or any kind of infections building up, we can pull those out. Okay. I think what I'm going to do is add a little bit of an antiseptic soothing treatment to the end of a cotton swab and just kind of swirl it around on the inside. That will make the swelling go down, reduce infection, all that good stuff. Very similar to like a saline base, but it has an antiseptic in it, so it's very gentle. But this is the side we seem to be a little bit more concerned about as far as infections. Okay. I feel nice and cool. Thank you. going to start with some general testing. I want to make sure that most of your cranial senses are being experienced accurately. So if you have anything like a concussion, that we can treat you appropriately. Okay. I'm just going to start with pressure sensation, given that you've had a couple of topical injuries, at least as far as we can tell. I'm just going to palpate the area very, very gently, and then to see whether or not there's any areas that are a little bit more drastic than the others. Okay. I'll try to be very gentle so that I'm not pulling on your hair, and if there is an area that's bruised or if it's painful, just let me know. I'll try to figure out the radius of it, okay? Alrighty. Just try to relax. And again, if there's anything that makes you feel uncomfortable, speak up, okay? Just gonna start with your forehead here. I'm gonna get a pressure in the belly and the eyes when I do this. I'm going to sit the same on both sides. And how about on the under eyes? And with my fingertips on the sides of your face here, if I just kind of palpate your cheeks and your jaw, so you do feel something on the side. Okay. If I press on where your gums are here, okay. I'm gonna take a look inside your mouth if that's okay. Just try to good to get a better look at the inside of your teeth, see whether or not you might have any root fractures or anything like that. Okay. I'm going to continue if it's okay. Yeah, that'll be something that we'll get a separate set of tests for, and get you an x-ray, make sure that if you have anything like broken roots on your teeth or fractures, anything like that, we'll see that best on a panoramic. I'm going to continue, is that okay? Yeah. Alrighty. So moving on to the front of teeth. Now just try to relax your mouth. But do tell me if this is uncomfortable, okay? Okay. And moving down to your jaw. Is the pressure even on each side? Okay. It's a little more so on the right because of the pain. Okay, but you can still feel. Okay. Moving up to your scalp. What's that? Behind your ears. I'm going to take my two fingers and just progressively palpate down the back of your neck on each side of your spine, okay? Any abnormal signs? sensations, any numbness. Okay. Shoulders. Okay. What about your biceps? Alrighty. I'm going to do a little bit of an exercise. I'm going to have you grab my two fingers. I want you to squeeze my fingers on each side and do it evenly. Give me all the pressure you can. Go for it. Good. So your strength is good. That's always good. I'm going to take two cotton swabs. And I'm going to very lightly touch your skin on both sides. I want you to tell me if it feels the same on both. Okay. And does this feel the same here and here? What about here? On the inside, right here. And here. On the inside of your collarbone. Here. And as I move out. Same on each side. Your forehead. Okay. If I move out, how does that feel? Okay. Very nice. I'd like you to fix your eyes on that beautiful view out the window. Find something to just look at and check your constriction and dilation of your pupils, okay? In doing this, it's going to be a little bit bright, so just try to relax your eyes. It's okay if your eyelids get heavy, and I'll just manipulate your eyelids so that I can look into the back of your eye as well as your iris, okay? Okay, and your pupils. Gorgeous. Take a look at that gorgeous view. And again, get it very close to you. Is that all right? Thank you. Just look forward. Okay. I'm going to lift your eyelid a little bit. Okay. Just apply a little bit of pressure. Your eye for a moment there. Okay. And pull down on your eyelid as well. Good. That's very good. Go ahead and blink. Very basic. If you've had head trauma, sometimes you can lose your sense of smell. So I'm just going to wave something in front of your nose and I want you to tell me what you believe it is, okay? Yep, rubbing alcohol. Mm-hmm. a really easy one to pick up on, but that does confirm that your nasal senses are functioning, at least on some very basic levels, so always very good. Do you feel like you have any strength in your arms or your hands? I'm just going to do some very basic coordination tests, so if you're able to hold out your hands, what I would like to have you do is to have one hand on top of the other and simply rotate it. Go ahead and give that a shot for me. Don't worry about being elegant, it's totally fine. Just want to make sure that you know the basic skills of rotating, tapping your hand very lightly. Very good. Okay. On the other side. Good. Wonderful. So you can go ahead and just relax. Rest your arms to your side. I'm going to test some coordination with your eyes. So even though your pupil restriction and dilation, or I'm sorry, constriction and dilation seem to be very responsive, I'm going to have you follow my finger. I'm going to go very slow, so just focus on the finger. I'm going to shine a light at you. I want you to focus on the corner, this guy right here. If you focus on that corner and you have the light, I want you to tell me when you see my two fingers move, okay? I think it is almost time for your next couple of doses of medication and some pain suppressants, so I'm going to just do some very quick listening to your chest, tapping on your chest a little bit, get your heart measurements, and then redress your bandage here. But for now, just try to relax. You don't have to focus on breathing, deep exhalation, that sort of thing. Just breathe normally, okay? I'm just going to take a moment and listen to your heart. Very nice. I'm going to go to the side here and listen. Around to your back. I want you to take some very nice deep breaths for me, okay? Okay, and just breathe in. And breathe out. Good job. Okay. And then. Thank you. time for me, okay? Good job. Your lungs and your heart sound good. Sounds good. Just gonna do some light tapping on your chest. I want to hear the echo to see if you have any kind of congestion, breakup, or if you feel the need to cough, okay? Some medication, and this is going to make you feel very, very sleepy, but we're going to monitor your brain waves, make sure that everything is stable, that there's no abnormal activity. So I'm going to just refill your IV, and you'll start to slowly doze off a little bit. Is there anything that I can get you beforehand? To you. This is not something that's going to make you go into a coma or anything. You still have the ability to wake up, but it will make you quite drowsy. Okay, so if you want something to drink, you're going to have water right next to you, okay? Okay. So give me just a couple of moments here and fill you up. Start to feel that kick in pretty soon. I'm going to redress your bandage up here. I'm going to apply the brainwave monitors so that we can watch you if and when you sleep, okay? Start with and moisturized. But the skin is healing very, very nicely. So it doesn't look like you're going to have any complication with that. And I don't think I'm going to reapply any of the butterfly bandages either. How does that feel? I should stay in place. And it doesn't look like you're going to need any on this side. I'll just go ahead and leave that open to heal, okay? Let's get you hooked up. You can feel the medication kicking in, can't you? More. That's good. Just temple area. How's that feel? Cool. All right. Another one. Let's get at some of those wires. And there we go. Okay, we're all hooked in. Slide some get caught when you move around a little bit. Okay. You feel a little more relaxed? Okay. Are you feeling a little bit more relaxed? Okay, that's good. You have water. So if there's anything that you need, don't hesitate to give us a ring and I'll come right back away. I'm going to take some notes about the soreness in your jaw area and see whether or not we can't get a doctor to make a recommendation to get you a panoramic scan of your jaw and your teeth. Okay. My lovely, I hope that you can some very healing and restful sleep. Just be a couple of feet away if you need me for anything else.